There are times you will need help in your life. Even though you are great, do not be afraid to be open for help. Financial help. Don't say, I'm divine. My supply comes from heaven. Yes, sir. There are times you just have to be honest. Please help me. I'm in a phase in my spiritual walk. I am still in the school of the spirit and I am not ashamed. There are many people who are sick. They secretly go and swallow drugs and come out and say, for 5 years, I've not taken any drug, because they are conscious of being a lion. Doctors are not a cost to the faith life. They are a system of God's mercy. If you are sick, release your faith. You release your faith and it looks like things are not happening the way you want. Please don't wait until your health deteriorates and you die. Be honest enough to go to the hospital while still in the school of the spirit. God's ultimate is that we become fortified to a point that there may not be need for those things. But whilst you are on that journey, take advantage of the supplies that cater for your humanity. There are people today who have died the death of fools. Identifying and admitting their humanity would have saved them trouble. Witnesses. Witnesses are not spirits of God. They are men. It is just that they are of God. There are people today who, in a bid to show the excellency of spirituality, have destroyed themselves. Can I tell you this? I'm not endorsing carelessness, but the body of Christ must be careful with this godlike expectation they have over men of God and leaders. Great men are men. The greatest and the best of us is still a man. There is, and I can tell you where that mistake came from. It came from us men of God. In a bid to show the excellency of the power of God, we feel ashamed of our humanity to our peril. If only you opened up your heart and let people know you needed help, you will be surprised how many people will be willing to help you. But when you let people know that you are God, you have so close a relationship with him, they will leave you there and you get punished for not being trained using this third face. Again, the lion, royalty and power. Then a call to service, the calf. But men will use you and strangle you. I told you here that a man of God, a father of faith in Enugu, he called me to his office after his conference and he said, Apostle, please be careful. Africans kill their prophets. He's not being sarcastic. He's saying once people identify the grace of God upon your life, they will suck you dry. Suck you dry. There are many people who are backsliding today because of ministry. They didn't have time for study again. 30 invitations in 1 week and you keep working for God and stop working with God. It is okay that when people call you and say, what are you doing now? Are you praying or studying? No, I'm resting. What are you doing? I'm just having time with my family. Don't you love the kingdom again? Shut your phone from those ignorant talk and focus on what God is giving you grace to do. Many great people today focused on building things and they left their family, they left the things that matter. Can I tell you this? I have learned by experience that only three things really matter in this life when all the stakes are down. Number one, your relationship with God. Number two, family. Number three, your assignment. End of discussion. There is nothing else that is worth dying for. Listen carefully. Your humanity was captured in the throne room. You can be tired. There are times you will need help. Yes, you are a man of faith. No matter how, even if a nurse and a midwife, no matter how professional she is, when it is time for her to give birth, she will need another midwife to also help her. Be careful when you reject